Right, everyone, me and Phil Turner from Timeform are going for the speed round. The speed roundup of all 40 runners in the Grand National. The aim is 5 minutes. The next aim or objective is to try and beat Mr Frisk's record for the National of 8:47.8. But the aim is 5 minutes. That's less than 10 seconds per horse. So, everyone, seatbelts on. Here we go. 2018 Grand National, starting with number one, Manila Rocco. Second in the Gold Cup, he's got that back class, but he's got jumping frailties. He's fallen or unseated three of the last seven races. Question mark with him about his capabilities for this.
Black Lion, fourth last year, won the Beecher in the autumn. Deserves to be one of the favourites. I've just got a nagging doubt that he won't last home up the straight just the same as he did last year.
Number three is Annibale Fly, one of the favourites by right, given he finished third in the Gold Cup. Was that a true reflection of him? It certainly suggested his stamina. He's a big player because he's ahead of the game in a handicapping perspective.
Last Samurai is number four. He's been placed three from four starts over the national fences. I expect another sort of good show from him. I think, all being equal, he should finish in the money again.
Number five is Valsalido. He was a class act once upon a time. He was a grade one winner last season, but he's a fading force overall and in terms of his recent races. Recent races, very doubtful about him.
Total Recall next. I think he should be clear favourite on his form this season and the way they're sort of handicapped. He's in form. He's got a fall from Cheltenham last time to overcome, but provided he takes the course okay, I think he's the best value in the whole race.
And Total Recall, on his reappearance, the start of this makeover, he beat a horse called Alpha Dizzo Bo. That horse is much better off at the weight with Total Recall, and that is the strand of hope for him. Has been misfiring more recently, but he has got that one piece of form. He has got some back class, and he looks to have loads of stamina.
Perfect candidate, likeable horse, lots of good races down the years, but pulled up last year, and just too high in the weights for me, avoid.
Chantu Flyer has got a bout of seconditis, but it's a really good bout in that he's improving his form, he's looking more austere. He's an interesting runner in this for his young rider, James Bourne.
Tenor Nivene, 17th last year, and although Venetian Williams is back in form, there'll be doubts about the trip, and I don't think he's necessarily going to improve much on that this time around.
Number 11 is Carlingford Hock. Who has had a hock injury.
You're wasting valuable seconds here, come on.
Right horse, wrong year. He's missed his opportunity to win a Grand National. He's now a dwindling, fading force at the age of 12. I don't think so for him.
Vicente's next. Dual Scottish National winner, but he fell at the first when trying the National last year, and jumping frailties are the obvious concern with him.
Tiger Roll is next. The heir apparent to Cause of Causes, but he's won many of the same races, he represents the same stable, but this is a horse who's still a tricky customer. He could throw in the towel at any stage in the National at the first attempt.
Regal Encore next. He was 8th last year, took okay to the course, but hold-up tactics aren't really the order of the day normally, and that'll be the doubt again with him. Plus, he can throw in the odd stinker.
Vieux Lion Rouge, if not before, why now? He's older, he's not so well handicapped, he's had a worse preparation. His chances have gone.
Chase the Spud next. He stays all day, plenty of form in the mud, but he's two really bad runs recently, and avoid for that reason.
Warrior's Tail, it's a case of course and distance with him. I can see him taking to the course at the first attempt because he's such a good jumper. I can't see him lasting the distance given what his overall profile reads.
See You at Midnight next. Potentially the best handicapped horse in the race on old form. And he's got a style of racing which would suit, but it's just a bit too much how much ability is there from his comeback run, and I think the fancy prices have gone with him.
Gastline Boy's got a really good track record. He's a 12-year-old now. He'll complete the course, but there are others better handicapped this year.
The Dutchman looked one for perhaps the national shortlist when winning at Haydock earlier this year, but he's bled when pulled up since, and that's an obvious concern turning up here.
Pleasant Company looks good in terms of who he represents, but not so good in terms of two misfires this season.
Uccello Conte, 6th in 2016, 4th in the Beecher later that year. Unseated at Beecher's when going well last year. Gordon Elliott, he's competitively handicapped, I think he'll run well.
St. R's got a record to be proud of around the national fences, but he won't be adding to it given how age has caught up and he's pulled up on both starts this season.
Beeves may be prominent for a while, but he's too high in the weights and can't fancy him.
Another go at the Grand National for Ras de Marie, a national veteran, won the Welsh version over Christmas, but very hard to see him make an impact at the age of 13.
I just know one at Catterick, the North Yorkshire National, that was by a long way, but this is far more competitive and I think he'll find it too tough.
And I think Virgilio is going to find it a shock to the system, given that he's never faced a race like this before and is coming in cold off a break on the back of a wind-up.
Bade Eel is an Irish mare who's been attracting a lot of money, stays very well, handles the mud, but I think the value's gone in the price and she's not the best handicapped runner, put it like that.
Maggio is a 13-year-old. The last time he tried these fences was 3 years ago, hasn't been near them since. I don't like him at all.
Pendra's next. Didn't stay in 2016 and I can't see any reason why it'll be different this time around.
Can you teach an old dog new tricks? That's the question with Barwise. Some evidence of this year suggests he is different. He got a vote of confidence from Leighton Aspel, who rode him a stand down to victory but can't ride him here. He's not out of this if his mind takes him.
Children's List is a Willie Mullins outsider, but he didn't stay on his last run and the trip's the big, big worry here.
Lord Windermere is a Gold Cup winner, but that was 4 years ago. He's had his chance and failed in Grand Nationals previously. Not for me.
Captain Redbeard was runner-up to the Dutchman at Haydock, which was a good run, and he's run well since. He comes in doing good form, but I'm not sure he took to the course all that well on his only previous try.
And Ublen de Zorbo was 10th in this last year. He's better handicapped, he's got softer ground, but equally, he's not as good as he once was. He's an 11-year-old, his days have gone.
Well, Bless the Wings is 13 now, and I think that is the doubt. He possibly is too long in the tooth, and I have slight doubts about him staying, even if he was in top form.
Milan's Bar has trained really well for this particular marathon. He's got the services of Bryony Frost. If he puts his mind to it, he's got a chance of showing up well for a long way.
Final nudge next. He's been a bit disappointed on his last two starts, and there's just a chance he might be in the handicapper's grip.
Double Ross, he's had his chance in these races previously, never looked to steer, therefore won't be at the age of 12.
Road to Riches was a top class horse in the past, but he's got absolutely zero chance on his recent evidence.
And there we go. We didn't beat the 5 minute marker, but we beat Mr Frisk and Marcus Armitage.
Well, there you go. Right.